All right, I think I have my microphone issue fixed, hopefully. So I'm gonna try this again. This is your key to the first part of the review. Remember that the white one, I'm just gonna post it worked out instead of me actually working out in a video. So the first blank says the larger angle in any triangle is across from the blank side. So the larger angle is always across from the longer side. And largest would be across from longest. So biggest with biggest, smallest with smallest. To solve a triangle, I'm gonna solve a triangle. No angles are known. That means it's a side-side-side situation. That would be the law of cosines. Law of sines, you have to know an angle so that you can set up your proportion. All right, SOHCAHTOA. That's where your sine, cosine, and tangent comes from. Can only be applied to solve blank triangles. All right, well, this is when you do the opposite over hypotenuse, adjacent over hypotenuse, opposite over adjacent. So we've been using the law of sines and cosines, but haven't been talking about SOHCAHTOA. That's because this H, which stands for hypotenuse, the only kind of triangles that have a hypotenuse are right triangles. When the law of sines is applied to, so law of sines applied to solve for an angle, that is the ambiguous case, and there could be zero, one, or two resulting triangles. Then, when two sides in an included angle, that's a side angle side situation, are known for a triangle, the blank is used to solve for a triangle. So, a side angle side is going to be the law of cosines. You wouldn't have enough information to do the law of sines, even if you tried. All right, so then Heron's formula, I believe on yours, well, this was highlighted, but you're supposed to fix that because yours says heroes. He may have been a hero, but his name is Heron. So Heron's formula is used to solve for the area. So it is an area formula. It's that weird looking one with the square root. And it is used when you have three sides. You don't have to know any angles or anything else, and you can find the area. All right, angles in quadrants one and two with the same reference angle will have the same blank value but different blank value. It's either sine or cosine. All right, so when we are looking at quadrants one and two, I know that sine and cosine are both positive here. Sine is positive here, tangent's positive here, and cosine's positive here. So if we're only looking at quadrants one and two, then whatever my reference angle is, they'll have the same sine value. But their cosine values will have different signs because it'll be negative over here. So they will have the same sine value, but different cosine value. Right, so if I want to solve the law of cosines for cosine of angle A, I mean, we can work out the algebra that gets us there. But really, it's just the other form of the formula. So remember, this one is going to give you, when you're looking for a side, and you know the other two sides and the angle that's included in them. But if you're looking for the angle, okay, the way this gets set up is it's a fraction, and you have all the sides. The sides go over here. And so since this is an a, you don't use the side across from it first, you use the other two sides. So b squared plus c squared. Then the one you subtract is the one that is across from this angle, so that would be a squared over 2 times these two multiplied together, b times c. Right, maximum value for the sine of an angle. So if you're ever unsure about how to answer a question like that, just think about your parent function. Here's your sine graph, right, your parent function, and so you know that's at 1 and this is at negative one, so your maximum is always your highest y value, so your maximum is one. If the cosine of an angle in a triangle is negative, so cosine of an angle in a triangle is negative, that means that the angle is blank. Well, again, when you think about your quadrants here, you've got, and since it's the angle in a triangle, we can only use quadrants one and two. So I don't even care about these down here. Those don't matter. It's quadrants one and two. So cosine is positive here and negative here. Well, this is 0 to 90. That's 90 to 180. So this is where it would be negative. It means the angle is obtuse. Now a little bit of a right triangle review. We did this, I think, before Christmas, but you also did it in geometry. So this is your SOHCAHTOA that you're using. The first thing we're going to do is draw and label our picture. So it's a right triangle. C is the right angle. And then one of them is A, one of them is B, and it doesn't matter which is which. And this is little A, which is 4. This is little C, which is 10. And this will be little B that I'm looking for. So if I'm going to solve the triangle, I've got three things. I've got to find the other two angles, and I have to find side B. I can actually find the side B, but this says to use trig. So I just need to follow those directions. So I can either find A or B first. It doesn't matter. I will find B first just because. The side, this is my hypotenuse, and this the adjacent. So I'm using adjacent and hypotenuse because I don't know that one yet. So that's going to be the cosine. So the cosine of B is equal to the adjacent, which is 4, over the hypotenuse, which is 10, which means the measure of angle B is equal to the cosine inverse of 4 over 10. So I'm going to go to my calculator. I'm going to double check that I'm in degree mode. Okay, and I want the cosine inverse of 4 divided by 10. And it gives me 66.422. And I'm going to store that. That was angle B. So I'm going to store it in alpha B. I'm just going to get in the habit of storing everything. Then I'm going to come back over here, and the measure of angle B is equal to 66.422 degrees. So there's angle B. Now that I have angle B and I know what angle C is, I can go ahead and find angle A. So I know that the measure of angle B, which I'm getting from my calculator, so I'm going to circle it because I already have it, plus the measure of angle A. Okay, so if I add them all three up, I know they equal 180, but since this is a right triangle, the acute angles are complementary. So those two added together have to give me 90. So now in my calculator, I can just do 90 minus alpha B, and then I'm going to store that in A, in case I need it here. And that's 23.578. So the measure of angle A is equal to 23.578 degrees. Now I still need to find little b. And so in order to do that, I'm going to use the trig. And I'm going to use this angle. It's a good thing that I have it stored. I'm going to take the sine of B. Okay, now the sine of B is what I have stored. It's just B, so I'm going to circle that part. That's equal to the adjacent, which means that little b is equal to 10 times the sine of my stored B angle. And that gives me 9.65. So B is equal to 9.165. Pay attention to if there's units somewhere, make sure you use the units. Make sure you have degrees on your angles. There will be units on the test. I'm going to make sure I put those on there. All right, so then another right triangle. So angle C again, oops, is 90. A is 32. I know little b is 12. I'm going to find little a, little c, and the other angle. I'm going to go ahead and eliminate my triangle. This is my angle. So this is the opposite side. This is the hypotenuse, and this is adjacent. So to find angle b, know that the measure of angle b plus 32 has to equal 90. B is equal to 90 minus 32, which is 58 degrees. Then I'm going to find, we'll do a little A next, so that means I'm going to use opposite, the adjacent is tangent, so the tangent of 32 is equal to the opposite, which is A, over adjacent, which is 12. It's the tangent of 32. So 32, and that's going to give me 7.98. So little a equals 7.498. That's not going to help me get C. Well, I guess I could, but it's better if I don't. So I'm not even going to worry about storing that. Then I'm going to go find little c using what they gave me instead of what I have stored, these three things here. So that's adjacent and hypotenuse, which is cosine. So the cosine of 32 is equal to the adjacent, which is 12, over the hypotenuse, which is c. Variables in the denominator, so they switch places. C is equal to 12 divided by the cosine of 32. So in my calculator, 12 of 32. And I get 14.150. So little c is equal to 14.150. Okay, there is your right triangle review. I think this next one's a right triangle also. It says from point A to B from the base of Peachtree Center Plaza. Okay, so here's Peachtree Center Plaza. That's what that is. And I'm at a point 3. The building is 65 degrees. All right. Well, this is my angle. So this is the opposite. This is adjacent. That means I'm using tangent. So the tangent of 65 equal to the opposite, which is h, the adjacent, which is 340. So h is equal to 340. Go 340 times the tangent of 65. So 340 tangent of 65 gives me 729.132. So h is equal to 729.132 feet, and that is the height of Peachtree Center. Oh. There is my answer. Okay. So now, in doing the first step in solving the given triangles, tell what side or angle would be solved for and whether the law of sines or cosines would be used. So I'm going to draw my triangle. 14. This is an A, B, C. So little a is 5, little b is 6, little c is 7. So that right there, this is a side situation, which means I'm going to have to use the law of cosines. And it really doesn't matter which angle I solve for first. It has to be an angle, obviously. A good rule of thumb is to go ahead and find the largest angle so that you can switch the law of sines if you want to. So my largest angle has to be across from the longest side. So I'm going to say we would solve for angle C. So then here, A, B, C. So A is 32, little a is 2, little b is 7. So this is a side angle situation. That is the law of sines. And it is actually the ambiguous case. You gotta be careful with that. That's what I mean by AC. I don't really have a lot of room to write all that. But in order to find that, or in order to do that, what I'm gonna do with the law of sines, it's a ratio. So the sine of angle A over little a is the sine of angle B over little b. Since that's where the information is that I have, I have to find angle B first. All right, then this one, A, B, C. So little a is 14, little c is 12, angle B is 38. So this is a side angle side situation. Do not have enough information for law of sines there, so it has to be law of cosines. And when you have that side angle side situation and you're using the law of cosines, then it's the third side that you find when you do that. So it would be little b that we would find, or line segment, or the length of AC. Either way, it's the same thing, but. All right, 17. We're gonna solve each triangle. We're either applying the law of sines or cosines. That's something that you have to decide on by drawing your picture and figuring out what you got. So here's A, B, and C. So A is 40 degrees, B is 30 degrees, little b is 10. Okay, so what I have here is angle-angle side. And since it is an angle-angle side, when you're given two angles to begin with, that is law of sines. So that's going to give me, to start, the sine of 30 over, so that's the sine of b over little b, which is 10, is equal to the sine of a, which is 40, over little a. Because I have to find little a and little c there. So then when I do that, I'm going to do 10 times the sine of 40. 10 times the sine of 40 divided by the sine of 30. And that gives me 12.856. I'm going to store that in A. I may not need it, but it doesn't hurt anything. So then I know that little a is equal to 12.856. Okay. In order to find little c, I need angle c, which I have enough information for sure. I know that 40 plus 30 plus the measure of angle c is equal to 180. So the measure of angle c is 110 degrees. So then that gives me that I have the sine of 30 over 10 is equal to the sine of 110 over little c. So 10 times the sine of 110 divided by the sine of 30. Okay, and it's 18.794. So little c is equal to 18.794. Then I'm going to stop here and then finish this in a separate video.